Well, hello and welcome back to Stockton Junction. I'm continuing the canal and Stonehenge areas, and I'll just show you where I'm at the moment. So I've started putting the cable trunking along the side of the track across the bridge. I've actually filled the holes that were in the bridge because I want to ballast across the bridge as well, just to tie it in. And with the canal and everything underneath, I don't want everything going down through, so I've filled the hole in. I've done the cable trunking all the way around to there, and you can see I've put some ballast in already. It's not glued in yet. I've also put scatters on here. I'm waiting for them to dry before I just hoover up, and then it will start to come up more like this. And I thought I'd show you also some how to speed ballast using the Bexhill West Hoover adapter parts. They're really, really good. So for those of you that think ballasting can take a very long time, I'm just going to move these out of the way. I'm just going brush in some glue and some water. So this is me ballasting. Now, you might think, wow, that's ridiculous. I'll tell you what. Let's just chuck it on there. I want loads in between and there, and any excess in this edge I can sweep up anyway. So I still need to get some more on these shoulders, but that's the whole point of this system that I'm using. Grab myself some more ballast. I did put a little bit too much in one area, but for people that think ballasting can take a long time, this new thing helps. Now, he does do a ballast spreader, which I wish I had got at this point in time, but I haven't got one yet. So the whole point of this is you have this adapter and a bottle. As you can see, there's something, it collects the excess ballast. So it's going to be a little bit noisy. I need to put my Hoover on. You have is, hope you can hear me, but you have this little adapter. So what I'm going to do, and as you can, you'll be able to see in a minute, it picks up all the excess. Look at that. Switch my Hoover off a minute. And as you can see, look, it's collected the excess. All I need to do is go around, sort the shoulders out a little bit. But it's pretty much picks up. It picks all of the excess out of in between the rails that you don't want. It's really good. Obviously, I've got to do a little bit, like I said, with the shoulders, but I'll do that with a brush. But yeah, really, really fast to ballast stuff with this, and then you can reuse what you've left in the bottle. And I'm going to continue on round there and get this whole section ballasted. So I'll see you when this is done. But this is really good. Like I said, it's from Bexhill West. On his webs, on his video about this, I know there's a link to where you can buy it. This is separate from the Hoover attachments. You get this and this, which is what he makes, and the Hoover attachments are on Amazon. But they're also really good as well. So, If I can find the links, I will try and put them in the description. But you can also use this to go up the edges like this as well. So I'll be doing that in a minute, but obviously I'm aware that the Hoover's really, really loud, so I don't want to be doing that on film. So I've put all the ballast in all the way around to there. It didn't take me that long. It took me, what, about 10 minutes. I did do a little bit. It took me a bit longer just to touch up the insides under the bridge, because it's really in the middle of the bridge, because it's really hard to get to, and underneath the tunnels and stuff. But literally using that tool, doing straight and flat sections is really, really quick. It also will do point work, which is really good, because you can put all your ballast in, not worrying, and it'll pick out all the ballast from the blades. If you find his video on Bexhill West's channel, you can see it in action. So it is really good. So next job will be to sort of put the ballast down, put the glue down on the ballast, and leave that to dry. And I need to also hoover that back section over there, ready to start doing some grassing up there, which I'm going to leave until this is all dry anyway. So I shall work on something else while I'm waiting. Well, I've done a little bit more. I've still got a bit of weathering to do there, where I had to replace some ballast that came out. But as you can see, I've started to do some track weathering as well to blend that in. I've started to do some grassing as on all the back there. I've just got that last bit there to finish off. I've got some scale model scenery fencing in place, and I just need to put a load more greenery, trees, bushes, all that sort of stuff in. But I mean, I think it's looking quite good. So when the trains are coming up again, especially if you've got a camera train, it's going to pick that Stonehenge out on the hillside there quite nicely, I think. So just have a look down. So yeah, it's looking quite good. So she'll get on and do a bit more. I haven't got all of the things I want for finish the area yet. I've still got a lot of detailing to do along the canal path. I've still got lots more stuff to do on these areas, and some interesting figures in the canal boat to get in there and all that sort of thing. So I have a plan for the Stonehenge area for a little scene that's going to be going on up there as well. So, but that's going to be in the future, because I haven't got all the parts I need, all the figures that I want for that area yet. So I've got to try and source those. But yeah, I thought I'd just show you where we're at. I did originally start using the scale model scenery fencing like that. I've ripped it out because I was having a couple of issues with it, but that's my fault, not theirs. It's a good kit. But then I changed my mind and wanted to use that scale model scenery fencing that you see there, which I quite like. So that does the job quite nicely, and it fits in the area well. So I need a little bit more of that though, because I've run out. So I need obviously to continue it all the way round to sort of here somewhere, and then I want a little fence going across the pathway where the car park will be. I'll have a little tiny car park down there somewhere for the people visiting. So, but yeah, I think it's coming on quite nicely. So we shall see that. I'll come back later on when I've done a bit more. Thanks for watching so far. Welcome back again, and I've done quite a bit more now. I've still got a lot more to do on this area. I've got things to put on the path. I've got the resin to pour for the final pour. They're prepped for repainting some of these sides, weathering these top edges, etc. But what I've done along the back, so put in one of the junction boxes there. I've still got to do the corner there by the thing, but so from there, that way hasn't been done yet, so that'll be done later on. But
As you can see, I've put in a lot of bushes, greenery, some little bits of flowers along here. Same. It's looking quite good, I think. I need to do a little bit more work, but as you can see, I've got a lot of trees in the back there now. Still got a whole load more up there ready to go along the back there when I finish that. I've only just grassed this area, so this needs to be hoovered off. I've got the path to finish. But where this line is quite a distinct colour. It doesn't come out quite so badly on the camera, but to the eyesight it's a lot green, it's a lot brighter, so I shall do something to blend those together a little bit. So I've got that to do. But for today, I'm going to be repainting these canal sides, because in places you can see some bits of plaster that got stuck in, and I painted them before I plastered it. And obviously I need to finish that off, and I've got a little like outlet there, so when I put the next water layer in, I've got to do some water effects for the water flowing out of the outlet there into the canal area. I've got some detailing to put along the pathway, some people that I'm in the middle of painting. Still need a little bit more greenery and stuff. Things to blend these edges in a bit better. So I've still got a bit of work to do on this lower section, but the back from there to there is all done now. I'm happy with that. I think it looks pretty good. So gonna move on, but I thought I'd show you where I'm at so far. I've got my main, I'm all set up ready. I've got my paints, my paintbrushes, my water, and a nice cup of coffee. So we're all good to go. So I'll come back later on. I'm not going to sit there and let you watch me sitting there just painting for the next hour, because it's going to probably take me in a couple of hours to do this. So I've got various paints. So the main base colour that I'm going to use, I find it looks quite good, is this engine grime. And then I've got a couple of rust colours and a nice slimy grime, which is quite good for a lot of waterline effect. And I'm going to use a bit of this as well, this corrosive stuff. This is brilliant if I can get it undone. Can't get it undone at the moment, so it's like a thick paste, but it comes up, if I can put that down, as you can see, it comes up with a nice texture when it dries, so it's really, really good. And then I'm going to try using this panel line to highlight the lines between the paving. So that's what I'll be doing now. So I've done the engine grime, done some of the paving joins and such like, so they stand out a little bit better. One paint I forgot to include was the rain marks effects, which is a very pale color. What I tend to do with this one, if I can get in, as you can see, it's so I just literally rub a load of this along the top edge and then just wipe most of it and blend it with my fingers. That gives a nice sort of waterline-y effect. I think that works quite well. I've still got lots more colors and details to add. But this, oh, I've got a bit of something I need to paint in there a bit better. But yeah, that's pretty good. So at this point of the video, I could just leave it like that. It looks pretty good. But we're now going to use the corrosion texture along the top edge there. So I did all the corrosive texture all along this top edge, and then I went across it with
the light rust to give the, because I'm obviously assuming that this is a metal type one, which I have seen images of. So the last job is I'm using the slimy grime dark. As you can see these little lines here, that's just a break up above the waterline. So I'm just literally so that will basically be the effect of the water light, water and slime and stuff just congregating on the edges. The idea is then to break up the water line, it going into the rust line like that sort of thing, and then obviously when I put the water in it's going to come up to around that line anyway, so it all should blend in quite nicely with the water. I know it's quite a lot of detail to go into, but that's just how I want it. So I think it's going to look quite good when it's finished, and it's the little details that make something stand out. I mean, when I pull back here, I think this section here looks really good. And obviously I've got a lot more detail to go along there. I've got some little mooring bollards from Scale Model Scenery that I'm going to put in as well. And a few other bits and pieces. And when I get the final layer on, and it's going to have a nice reflection as well. So when you're looking down, you'll get a lovely reflection of the bridge. It's all murky here because unfortunately, when I did all the gluing area for all of this and all this, it ran down into here and ruined the top effect. That's why I'm going to put another layer over the top just to give it a full shine. Plus, obviously, I need some water effects coming out where the sluice is up there, just there. So, and I'm going to have a little boat coming through here somewhere, or maybe still on bit further under the bridge just coming out. I've got some special people that I want to put in here, which I'll tell you about later when I get them painted up, because I'm still in the middle of doing that at the moment. So I'm going to just finish off this area and just come back and show you what it looks like when it's fully done. Well, it's Easter Sunday today, and I'd like to just say happy Easter to everybody. And thanks to all my viewers for watching my channel. Really appreciate it. I'm up to currently at the moment 903 subscribers, so that's really, really good. I'm quite amazed actually. Anyway, I've done the last pour on the canal. As you can see, it's got a lovely reflection now. It's still in its last process of drying at the moment. It's got about another 6 or 7 hours, so I don't want to touch it. And I've still got a fair amount of detail to be adding along here. I've got some watercraft that I've ordered as well that have got to be painted up and put in. I've got obviously figures, bollards, all sorts of other things to go in this area. So I'll do that in my next update video when I've got those all in place. But I think it's looking pretty good. I've added a bit more stuff to it. I've still got more to add. As you can see, I've started to add a few trees to the foreground. I want to put a few more bits along here, but I don't want to put them in until I've started working on this area, because I don't want to lean over to work in the back bit and break anything that's there. So I shall leave that for now. But it's looking pretty good. I'm quite happy with that. And as I said, the glue's all dried along here now, so all the little flowers and things are all showing up quite nicely, and Stonehenge is in place, obviously all done. I've still got a little bit more blending to do with some bits across here just to blend those two colors in a little bit better, and obviously continue the fencing around there. But I'm not going to worry about from here, I'm not going to worry about this side yet until I start to put in the next section here. So I just wanted to get one area sort of scenically done. So I've got somewhere to at least do some reasonable running shots. And speaking of which, I will have a couple of trains running through. I also want to see what the reflection looks like with the train going across with the reflection underneath. So we'll look at that in a second. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video and liked the progress so far. Please feel free to comment. I always enjoy comments. And if you haven't, please hit the subscribe button as that will really help my channel. And hit that like button if you like the video. Thanks for watching. I have got another video I've already started on for the next area, but I'm not going to give you any spoilers. So hopefully that'll be out in the next couple of weeks for the next area that I'm working on. So anyway, thanks for watching and see you all soon.